In the meantime, it's now time to talk to this week's guest, who is Deirdre Robb from Belfast Exposed. And our topic is an unusual one for the radio, as it's photography. To me, Deirdre, photos are important, and without them, I wouldn't be able to remember some of the details of where I've been and what I've seen.
I suppose the way we view photographs are, they're like memories that we put in a wee box, and we all look back in our family albums and the memories we've had over the years, and the power of photography can really bring you back to that moment in time, which is actually special. And normally people take photographs when there's something special happening to them. So there's a real magic with that. And I suppose that's carried through Belfast Exposed, who's been here for nearly 40 years.
If you look back to the darker times here, if you didn't have the photographs, you wouldn't realise that, for those who haven't lived through it, you wouldn't realise what it was like. In fact, sometimes a still image can mean more than a moving image.
It can indeed. And I suppose the trauma of those darker days, and we use an awful lot of our images that would be in our archive that would actually support people who's trying to move on. And it is actually, the power is because we all look at it and we all have a different story and a different narrative that we put to it.
And in the past, you had this whole cumbersome thing about taking photographs, apart from forgetting to put the film in the camera, which some people did. Have you noticed the fact that photographs taken across the years have become more snapshots of real life? Is it easier now?
It's so much easier now. The fact is, you don't need to have a big fancy camera to be a photographer nowadays. Everybody's engaging with it, from young people right through to the older generations. It's that accessibility and that instant aspect of it that is actually really quite powerful. In fact, people don't really buy a phone for the phone anymore. They buy the phone for the use of the camera in it. So yes, it is, and more people and more are getting engaged in it as well.
Is part of the problem the fact that often photographs stay in your phone? There are some wonderful gems of photographs taken and nobody sees them apart from the person who has taken them. But you change that. You obviously encourage people to put things online, to put things, to have physical copies as well.
Yeah, I think it is important that, because whenever we change our phone, sometimes a lot of those images, etc., can be lost. And the fact that we're not printing out is our inability to maybe sometimes share. Even if you go back to the concept of a family album, it was also sharing with your family and with other members of your wider community some of those memories that you've had. So we're very active encouraging people to either post them online, like some of the competitions that we do, but also even printing them out and creating your own family albums.
People can't go and see exhibitions at present. Has that changed how Belfast Exposed has worked over the last year and a bit?
Oh, for sure. It has been a challenge in its own way, but we've embraced the world of digital, all things digital, and our communications has been not only looking at how we can do it digitally, but how different ways that we can do it. Even a lot of our workshops, we do an awful lot of training programs, even a lot of our workshops, we're now doing it online and communicating online. I suppose we've learned new kind of systems as well. I don't know if the fact that we engage in Zoom so much nowadays has been a massive change and a wonderful change, because we're now able to connect with people, you know, all over the world at the touch of a button. But yes, so our online is being very active and being very proactive as we continue through it.
Like every organisation, especially a not-for-profit one, funding is a major thing. You have two major sponsors?
Yes, our principal funder would be the Arts Council of Northern Ireland, and also Belfast City Council fund us on an annual basis. And I have to say, they have been so supportive to us throughout the course of this. You know, they've been flexible funding, and they've been working for us on our behalf as well as trying to attract additional funding. So we've been quite fortunate that we've been able to maintain our presence due to them.
Let's move forward to what's happening at present. I'm sure there's lots of things. In fact, you have a great website. I would encourage people to go to it. And before I forget, can you tell us how they would navigate to there?
It's www.belfastexposed.org. And within that, we have a range of information about, you know, maybe just about our background, but also about the number of wonderful exhibitions that we have and also some of the conversations we've been having with artists and communities as well.
And it's time to go back to Deirdre Robb from Belfast Exposed. Deirdre, let's talk about this competition to encourage people to take and submit photographs of nature. Tell me more.
Belfast Exposed have teamed up with Translink, and I suppose the idea behind the whole is a photographic competition. And I suppose the whole idea behind that was to mark the first kind of year of lockdown, which is the 23rd of March. And within doing it, we wanted something that was really positive and that celebrated the resilience of people, I suppose, and how people have coped. And in many ways, people through their daily walks and exercises, etc., have went out and have taken photographs of the world around them and connected to their environment and to nature. And so we felt, what better way to celebrate it than to invite people into a competition to show us their images so we can produce an online exhibition and an exhibition later on in the year in Belfast Exposed as well. So really all we're asking for is people's images of nature and the world around them to send them in to us and support our competition.
And of course, nature isn't just wet in the countryside. You can go for a walk along these greenways and nature is on your doorstep.
Nature is on your doorstep. And there is some people who have been shielded that can't really get access to the outdoors. So even the nature that you have in and around you, should that be a small flower, and you want to see some of the creative stuff that people have shown us. So it doesn't have to be up in the, you know, the mountains. It can be a short walk around the corner. We have photographs, I think it's came in of caterpillars and birds, all sorts of things, as in urban environments as well as outdoor nature.
How successful has it been? I got a number from a few days ago, but I'm sure it's grown since then.
We've got about 250 responses so far, so we're really delighted with that. And that's only been, we've only been launched at 4 weeks, so we're doing very well.
And there's a little bit of an incentive as well.
Yes, we do have a number of prizes. There's going to be six of shortlisted candidates who are going to get the work printed and framed. But also for the one prize winner, there's going to be a voucher from Wex, which is a photographic store. We're going to have a £100 voucher from Belfast Exposed to engage in our training programs or to purchase some of our books. And also there's like a 4-week travel with Translink Island cards. So actually, it's pretty nice prizes there, I have to say.
Earth Day, as we mentioned before, is coming up on the 22nd of April. So is that the date by which the entries have to be in?
Yes, that's the final date, which is on the 22nd of April. And we thought Earth Day was a perfect way of sort of connecting with the nature theme, obviously, but also was about encouraging people to look at nature and to respect it as well. And as we enter into our world, our new future, one of the things in the pandemic has been a new refined respect for nature. So we're very keen to continue that through.
To send the entries in, is there anything specific that they need to understand?
If you have an Instagram or Twitter, any kind of social media, just post it on hashtag naturalconnections2021, or you can email it into naturalconnections@belfastexposed.org.
Go for your walk, take your phone with you. No, it doesn't even matter what the weather is. Just keep on taking pictures and you'll find one that's good enough to enter, I'm sure.
Absolutely. And it's about looking at the world around you, even up at the sky. We've had some beautiful images and dramatic skylines. Northern Ireland is such a wonderful, beautiful place that we maybe have forgot to notice a wee bit. So it's about bringing out that, even the coastlines. As you say, sometimes even in your back garden, there's amazing the world of nature that you can find there.
So let's remind people to send the photograph in. The hashtag is Natural Connections
2021.
Got to get that right. If they go to your website, will they also find some details there?
Oh yes, the information's all there and all you have to do is click in.
Okay, that's excellent. Deirdre, thank you for your time. It will be encouraging to see the variety of entries that you get, and maybe whenever it's all over, you'll come back and you'll tell us all about the winner and the sort of variety of stuff that you've received.
Oh, delighted to. It'd be wonderful. Thank you.
Let's just remind you about the details for the competition through Belfast Exposed. Their website is belfastexposed.org. The hashtag you need to enter if you do using social media is naturalconnections2021. And the email If you want to send them that way, is naturalconnections@belfastexposed.org.